Hello, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy Tactics Rebirth. Now, I know I said I would be heading down here to Bethlehem Garrison in the last episode, but I actually realized that once you clear Zeltenia Castle, you're actually able to begin doing the side quests for Chapter 4, or rather, the only side quests in the game. So I made my way all the way down to Goog, and got started with that. So there's a small scene that plays. Steel ball found. Is that Pisces? It might be Pisces. Correct me if I'm wrong. Anyway, let's just watch this scene for completion's sake. I didn't want to watch it originally and then walk all the way up here and get in like 400 random encounters and then upload a like 5-hour long video. So the alternative was for me to just do it this way. So it's pretty cool that they have the zodiac signs built into the font set for this game. Just goes to show how important zodiac signs are to the game itself. So anyway, that's what happened in Goog, and now we carry on the story by going to the bar in Goland. We check out the rumors, and we see this new rumor, the ghost of Colliery. Okay, so we have to slay a monster in the mines, but we can't do that right away. So let's head up to Lasalia. Since Zelmo is no more, he won't be bothering us this time around. Well, we've got the next best thing, don't we? So we got Beowulf. It's speculated because Beowulf's sprite is so similar to Wygraffs that his sprite was originally a alternative sketch or prototype for Wygraff's sprite, and the other hint that sort of points to that is that his name is Beowulf, and then Wygraff's name is Wygraff, which could also be translated or transliterated as Wiglaf. And Wiglaf is a character in the story of Beowulf, in the poem of Beowulf, which is, you know, the famous Old English poem, one of the only surviving Old English poems that we have. And so Beowulf will be joining us shortly. He is kind of like a mix of a holy knight and an oracle, but he has some other skills too, like shock! ! But we won't really be using him, so it's not all that important. Just interesting to have him in the party. And, I mean, yeah, all these characters we're going to be recruiting, we aren't going to be using any of them. But they are nice to have around, and it's cool to just do this for completion's sake. So, we've finished that requirement for going into the battle. And now we're going to head back to Golan to check out this mine. So, as you can see, the Golan turned red there, because it is a dungeon now. Alright, I have no recollection of this level whatsoever. Yeah, I should mention that in the various random encounters I ran into along the way to Goog and back, I was able to get enough job points for Cecilia to get the Leviathan summon, and for Agrius to finish her job requirements as a wizard and move on to becoming a Time Mage. So we're getting closer to Lunar Knight. From what I understand, these chemists in this mission are fighting us for some reason, unspecified reason. It's a lot of chemists. Some of them will have the flame gun on them in vanilla FFT, but perhaps they don't in Rebirth. They don't. They do have flash hats, which are nice, but we don't need any more of those, really. So, we can just massacre all these enemies, at will. They don't have anything we especially need. So I think what I'm going to do is cast haste on myself. Lavian. Or perhaps... Yeah, let's do that. Why not? And get you out of the way. Well, actually, this would probably be a better place to hide. So, I'm going to do the obvious thing here, I guess. Nice. Gunshots. Shots fired. Oof. Song for the moment. Thought I might be able to squeeze that one out, but yeah, actually, if you look at it, it's quite an elevation difference there. Okay. For some reason, I faced Ramza towards the wall again, too. I don't know that's with me. I should note that I got up at 5:30 in the morning today, and I've took a brief nap, but I've been up ever since then, so my thought processes might not be entirely clear in this mission here. I might be able to actually go Nameless Dance and then just move up here. Fly is pretty awesome. Leviathan on one of these guys just to see how much damage it does. Look at Beowulf being totally useless. He's walking back and forth. I mean, I don't really fault him. He doesn't have any skills yet, so. Maybe he has been buffed enough to actually be good. He wasn't too bad in vanilla, as far as I remember. And again, oracles are much better in Rebirth, so you may not really be competitive with them in the end anyhow. Yeah, it's that snow geomancy skill. Cool. Alright, prepare to get a taste of your own medicine. I really wish these guys had flame guns, because they were supposed to.
Ugh.
But why not? Let's do it. Damage isn't that fantastic. They'd at least use high potions on this game. There you go. Beowulf did something useful. It says plus zero brave, but it's actually plus 100, so should make a slight difference. Exactly the same amount of damage. Brave doesn't factor into it at all, into the calculation. Ooh. Ooh. I shouldn't be so hard on him, he's just a useless, special character. Oh, come on. Of course we could exploit this. But, I'm not really too interested in doing that. Yeah. I will try to kill him with Agrius, just so she can get a little bit more job points. And I can't steal anything from him. Unfortunately, so... just dance the night away. Keep trying, man. Eventually you'll get it. Oh, you did it. You're a winner. Crystal could be useful, but I really don't think that they're going to have Elixir, which is the only chemist that we don't have yet. And when I was out going from Zeltenia to Guggen, then back here, I did pick up quite a few poaching items. One of them was an Elixir, so that's kind of cool. I also got a Kakusha, one of those items that we were trying to steal off of the assassins, but of course it isn't the weird, you know, accessory slot Kakusha, it's the actual helmet one. So it's considerably less good, but still a decent item. What else did I get? Nothing too exciting. Oh right, I got a another perfume that gives you protect and shell, auto protect and shell, which I think I got off one of those like Marbo enemies. You know, the ones that have all the tentacles and cast bad breath. In most Final Fantasy games. Those things used to freak me out in, like, FF7 when I was a kid. Not only because they could, like, wipe your whole party, but because they were creepy as well. I mean, I've always been a little bit creeped out by creatures with many tentacles. I think most people are, but it seems like here in Japan, a lot of people are just kind of okay with it. I'm not referring to, you know, usual tentacle thing when people talk about Japan. I'm talking about like octopi and stuff. People just like aren't creeped out by them. They're like, oh yeah, they're just there. Or like squid or something. They freak me out, but most people, I guess, are just used to them here. So we're still at level 2 time mage. Might as well grab something else. Don't move. Would be useful. And, Summoner's probably not able to do much of anything. Other characters can do anything. I don't know, maybe Beowulf can take a new ability. Let's see if he can. No, he just failed so often that he wasn't able to actually accumulate any job points. Okay, here we go, on to battle number 2. Lots of thieves, which means lots of charm. Oh, there's a Bahamut here, or a behemoth. Try to recruit that guy. And what you can do is you can recruit monsters, rare monsters, and then you you recruit the rare monsters, and then you get them to breed offspring, and then you bring them into battle, and then you kill them with your character and poach them, and that way you can just like farm poached items off them. It's a horrible, cruel thing to do, but oh, this guy does have a blaze gun. Okay. Okay. Now we're talking. Shoots ice elemental bullets. So that is a must get for us. We definitely want that. So we have to think about what we're doing here. The first thing I'm gonna do is try to go over here and cast stop. I can't do it. That puts us in an awkward position, doesn't it? Ow. So, there must be some kind of text input error there, because obviously he's doing fire damage, not ice damage. Those thieves, man. I tell ya. Not a fan. Oh, crap. Alright. What's this guy got going on? He has a flash hat. I could steal one from him. Damn it, Beowulf would be so bad. Okay. No. damn it. Well, that might be the end of this attempt. This mission. Oh crap! Oh no! Ooh, that's interesting. So I don't think I can Damn it! Gotta give it a try. As I said, lack of sleep leads to poor decision making. So, bye. I can't believe he could tank that. It's pretty impressive. Awesome! Did something useful, man! So I'm going to try to do a little of this. Be good. I had to take that guy out, even if he does have a flash hat. So, I'm gonna bring this summoner back to life. Thank you. That's awesome. Huh? Oh, okay. He tried to act and then he couldn't. Oh, because he's berserk. I understand now. So. presents us with an interesting dilemma. Yes! Nice. Got ourselves a King Behemoth. So, what could I do to steal this stuff? I guess the only thing I can really do is, like, move away and then hope that he moves to do something for us. And I think the Behemoth, I'm just going to try to poach his stuff. I'm not going to try to invite that one. Because, you know, not quite as interesting. I want to get a bit closer before I do this. Try to cast on the unit so he can't run away. Come on, come on. No! Move for me, man. Move! Move somewhere! Yes! Yes! Thank you. Okay, so... No! Ah! Damn it! So, yeah, Rams increasing our speed should help. We only need our Dancer to land the killing blow. Not a huge deal though, because she does have re-raise. Kill him. I do want to poach. Really hope that stop doesn't trigger on our Dancer. The only thing we have to do is get this guy somehow. Nice! We got it. Alright! Rams is gonna be happy about that. Is still not dead. We need to go take care of it. And first, to whittle down. Alright. This guy dies. Now we could have waited and probably got elixir off of the corpse of our of that chemist, but I didn't really want to bother with it. Yes, at the party. Let's dismiss old units. I say we get rid of you. Chocobo. Got a badass in our party now. Yes, save the game. I think this is the last mission in this series, which is a good thing, because we're running pretty long, and I'm also almost falling asleep. As you probably tell from my rather lethargic commentary here. So, obviously, first things first, let's get that blaze gun going. Yeah, so a huge damage difference we get from that, which is great. So she's got her Time Mage level she needs. And that means she now needs to move on to either Summoner or Lancer or Samurai. So, let's see. Can you become a Lancer? She can become a Lancer. Alright. That's good. I like that. Get her some decent items again. Some decent, damage and so forth. So on and so forth. So let's see, can we just get like the let's do that. Just in case, we might want to use it. So how many levels does she need in Lancer? She needs only two levels, so she needs one level in Lancer from what she has now. So that should be an easy thing to achieve. Oh yeah, the other thing I picked up was another bracer. There was that discounted bracer I could buy at the fur shop, and I used that to replace Rad's power glove. Nice. Must have been auto-equipped at some point, because I know I didn't equip it. I think everybody... yes, right. We no longer have a helmet for her, so we might as well use this Kachusha we picked up. And, I think we're about good to go here. So, what happened? We got a nice King Behemoth. We got a nice blaze gun for Ramza, and now we're going to get another new character. All good. All good. So let's see what we run into in this mission. Dragons. Ooh, it's an Uribo. Get the Uribo. Gotta recruit the Uribo. So, what do we need to look at? What do we need to look out for? Dragons are scary. That's pretty obvious. Throw a gun. No big deal there. If we could steal their flash hats, that'd be cool. But really our main concern is the Uribo. Aww. Looks like a cute boar. Totally useless, but poaching it does give you good stuff, I believe. Alright. So. What do we have to look out for in terms of long distance attacks? Well, their guns are a little bit scary. I will move up here. Let's cast haste on Agrius. I need to get Ramza all the way up there so that he can recruit the Uribo. This is the kind of situation where move plus 3 comes in handy. And, otherwise, let's, just aimless dance. Try to get behind some cover. Beowulf will do what he likes. I think I should move over here with my geomancer with Rad. Doesn't need that, but I will use a high potion on. I think this geomancer slash chemist combo is working out really well for us here. Lightning! That's more like it. None of this stupid caster crap we've been dealing with. This is the Agrius I know and love. Oh, wow. Dragons are so strong. Did I mention the dragons are strong? Because they are very, very strong. I think I will want to be, well, that's good. Hopefully good. I think I will want to try to charm one of the dragons if possible. Please work. That's all I can say. Please work. So I could try to use a summon. I think what I want to do is here. Let's do what I cast. Okay, that'll do it. Ideal if I could turn one of those dragons into a frog. No. Oof. Alright, okay, good. Got a fighting chance here. So, just gonna bring Agrius back to life, nothing too fancy. Oh, the Uribo attacks! Okay, what do we want to do next here? Charm Dragon. I want to get a stop on this dragon. Slowly kill it. Don't kill the Erebo! Okay. Definitely need to make recruiting the Erebo our number one priority. Come on, Erebo. You know you want to join me. Thank you. dagger should kill him. Good. Next, we'll try to cast Stop on this dragon. Okay. Thanks, pal. Attack of the Uribo 2. Yeah, I suppose I might want to poach one of those dragons. Okay, cool. Come on, Uribo. Ah, stubborn bastard. Cool. Got it. Yeah, I forgot about that. So Agrius can come down there, I guess. And I think she but soon she'll be able to reach them. Kill this guy quite yet. But I do want to keep Rat around in case I do need to kill him in a hurry. I'll just move over here so I can grab the crystal off this guy. And will you give in, Uribo? Make sure that guy stays stopped. Great! Got him. Too much she can do. guess she'd heal herself for closing it. So that will kill him. Again, another case where there's not much I can do. Just, sit around and wait. Make sure that dragon doesn't get healed up. Is Revo gonna get the kill? Oh, I thought he would for a second. No, Rebo, don't do it. Ah! No. To make some more room in our party anyway, just so our monsters can breed. There's another level? Are you kidding me? Oh man, when will it end? So you need to go. And I guess it's time I start getting rid of these units too. Sorry guys. Been with us from the beginning, but we don't need your services anymore. Keep Redford around. He's a stalwart of my party. So yeah, thanks for letting me know about this on the forums. Alright, so we got some room now. We got some behemoths and some Rebos. So we got our Lancer job, we need it. Take that. Here you can have that crappy mithril sword. Rune blade was. marginally useful skill. Might as well take it. I mean, it definitely has its uses, but at this point, we're just gonna have her as a monk for a very brief period of time. So, got all of the summons! Finally! Chapters and chapters later, battle upon battle, we have achieved the impossible. But we still have to get half of MP. Then we will finally be done with Summoner, and we can get her a decent support or auxiliaries skills. I ask why I keep Boker around, because he's so useless. It's because he's a special character. He was, in the first place, he was Wygraff's mount in Chapter 1, but aside from that, he was also a character in Final Fantasy V. He was the main character's chocobo. So, can't get rid of him. I mean, if we have to, we will get rid of him, but I'm a little bit attached to the idea of keeping all our special characters, if we can. Hopefully I didn't horribly screw something up in the setup there. And I'm not going to try to steal anything in this map. I'm just going to try to kill the enemies because I'm far too tired to carry on this way. Alicia, there she is. Curious. Oh, I only have four characters, so tough choice. You know what? I think Aries is our weakest character, so I'm gonna leave her out. Or the weakest link. Bye. This mission. I feel like Agrius actually would have been really useful here. As a holy explosion, but oh man, it's rough. Wow, heard it, okay. If I could poach one of those guys, that'd be great. But so we might have to retool our characters to take into account the problems we're gonna face in terms of status ailments on this map. stuff. Of course, you can't use her as this dragon. Something that would like get rid of status ailments for us. I guess that's not the case. So, cast haste on you. This is good because it should also give Reese a bonus. Might switch over to Life Song after this because the enemies aren't doing that much damage to her, so it may be possible to just use that. Oh, come on! It may be possible to use Life Song and then keep her alive for a while. I think this would be a good spot to turn on my erstwhile ally. What are you doing? Oh, I see. Pretty good idea. Well done. Contribution is appreciated. Forgot to take the eye drops, I guess. It would come back to haunt me someday. So yeah, I'll just use a high potion on her. Thank you. Reckoned House. Should be able to poach the enemy. Or this battle's over. Bree should be able to kill that demon herself. Like, there's no way I'm wasting a remedy on this, so just wait. Wait. Should give us a really good item. That gun. That was weird. Your second attack also manifests as magic, even though it's a gunshot. Must be some kind of weird thing to do with the fact that guns aren't normally able to be equipped in two hands. Goodbye. Didn't really need my help, but kept her alive long enough, I guess. Alright, we did it. We actually cleared the mission. Only took us an hour and a half. Can use her as a dragon. Right, and in vanilla, it's like she's way better as a dragon than she is as a human. Not to spoil anything, but in Rebirth, her human form has been considerably rebalanced, so I'm quite excited to see what they've done with it. Alright, so that is the end of this side quest. And, next time, we will, maybe try to go on to, oh, we can't go on to quite the next one. I will go get Worker 8, and then, after that, we will, we'll continue with the story, and once we unlock the potential to go to the next side quest, we'll do that when we have the chance. So, thank you for watching. Sorry I was a little bit out of it this time, but we did get through it, and if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe, and we'll be getting back to the attack on Bethla Garrison in the next video. I'll do the Worker 8 thing off-screen. Right. I hope you'll watch that video then, and good night!